Welcome back. Costa Vida. Have you heard about the place? It is known for its great burritos and nachos. But starting today, they're also going to be known as a big supporter of the Salt Lake Mission. William Bruce from Costa Vida is joining us to tell us more about this. Is really a brand new program that you guys are partnering up with. You want to help feed the homeless. Welcome to our show, by the way.
It's good to be here, man. Thanks for the welcome.
I love how this this came to fruition for you. I mean, it was the middle of the night. You're thinking
it
about
was.
Food.
Just let it out that I stay up late. You're right. And that's right. It was a documentary on Dive, and it was about how grocery stores throw their food away after it expires, but it's still good after that date.
Yeah. And several days, it's still good.
Right.
Yeah.
And so I thought the same thing. We have to make enough. We have to over-prepare rice, tortillas, beans, so that if you come in at 9 o'clock, we have enough food to serve you. It's like Subway. We have Subway, too. We have to make a lot of bread, and we have leftover. So I thought, let's pull it all together and make some enchiladas and burritos and change the flavor week to week, and here we are. It's a humbling experience.
How much leftovers are we talking about? I mean, do you guys, I mean, have a number on it in terms of weight?
We do. We put anywhere from 240 to 350 pounds together a week.
That's a lot of food.
It is. And that's, you know, half the week. I wish they would eat, everybody could eat Mexican food every day. I think I could.
You probably do, don't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, I do.
Wow.
My wife and I.
So when you went to the mission with this idea, what was the reception? I would imagine like, yay, thank you.
They were. And it was kind of another humbling experience. The operator there said, really, you're going to deliver this food on a certain day? And I said, yeah. He says, well, that gives my cooks a break on, you know, on Thursdays. And I said, yeah. And it's, yeah, it gives you a break and it gives us an opportunity to help the community. And that's what it's all about. And it's been I tell you, in our first delivery, we needed help because there was, you know, 30 trays of food to deliver. And I said, hey, can we get any help? And the guy inside the mission over the speaker system said, can we get some help? And here we had 30 people come out of the mission, and they were hugging us, saying, hey, they were grateful. And, you know, that's yeah, it is what it is.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Yeah.
It really is. So what days do you deliver? What days?
Every Thursday. Like today's one of those days where we deliver every Thursday morning. And I had the opportunity because the director, his name was Chris, he invited me to eat with them today. And I'm kind of excited to do that too.
Are you hoping that other restaurants or other, you know, grocery stores or, you know, people that have food or places that have food jump on this bandwagon?
Wouldn't that be neat?
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, if we could do that as a community, we probably wouldn't have anybody hungry.
I know.
And you know, how many of us in our own homes throw away groceries out of the refrigerator because vegetables go bad? And that's when I was sitting there thinking, wow, we throw away a lot.
Yeah. Did you know that this week is Random Acts of Kindness Week?
No.
You're doing a random act of kindness. So
here
there
we are.
You go. Yeah, it is. It is Random Acts of Kindness Week. So if you someone comes up and gives you a flower or a burrito,
yeah,
say thank you.
I'm with Ann.
Thank you so much. Great meeting you.
Thank you. Nice to meet you, too.
Yeah, have a great lunch today.